Donald Trump's lawyers went to court this week on his behalf and basically begged the judge to slow down the case where Donald Trump is fighting to protect his records from being released to the January 6th Select Committee. And the reason, or the way, I guess I should say, that they're slowing this down is because they have requested that Donald Trump and his lawyers have the opportunity to review every single document that has been requested by that committee, which is a process that could literally take months to even years to do, given the volume that they have requested, the committee has requested. But the lawyers also tried to argue another point that was patently false. This is what they said to the judge in their 33-page filing. Both the FBI and Senate have confirmed that there was no coordinated effort, including at the White House, to overturn the election on January 6th. FBI said that, right? Problem is they didn't. The FBI did not, in fact, come out and say that. The Senate did not come out and say that. This was a lie. It was a lie written into your court filing. And I'm just sitting here wondering how you're not being held in contempt for lie. You can't lie in a court filing. Judge, I don't know if you're a fan of Ring of Fire here. If you are, thank you very much. But here's the thing, Judge, freaking hold them in contempt. You can't just blatantly lie in a court filing. You can't purposefully lie in a court filing. And yet here they are. They're saying things that we know are not true. They're verifiably not true. The FBI didn't say that. The Senate didn't say that. And in fact, that's actually what the committee is trying to figure the hell out. They're trying to say, was there coordination? Was there an effort to overturn the election on January 6th? And from all the available evidence that we can see out there, it's pretty clear that there was. But the committee wants, you know, to get all their ducks in a row, get all the evidence, make a rock-solid case before they declare it. But those of us living in reality can see the writing on the wall. We can see what actually happened that day. We remember. I mean, after all, they did come from a Stop the Steal rally. The steal, of course, being the certification of the Electoral College votes that was taking place later that day. That's why they chose that day. So you can't sit there and try to say there was no effort to overturn the election when that is 100% what that entire day was about for Donald Trump and his friends. If the judge doesn't want to hold them in contempt for lying in the filing, whatever. I hope it just gets outright dismissed. The National Archives submitted their filing this past Saturday, where they rejected Donald Trump's claims of executive privilege, of course saying that he's not the executive, and the real executive said, we can give over the documents, so we want to do that. Donald Trump doesn't have a legal leg to stand on. And if this is the best that his lawyers can do, then yeah, he's definitely going to go down in flames. But the judge shouldn't even let it come to that. Dismiss the case, release the documents, so we can get to the bottom of this.